With iOS 13 no longer supporting the iPhone 5S, is it worth it in 2019, especially given the amazing prices? Now, the iPhone 5S was supported for a good 5 years by Apple and has to go down as one of the greatest iPhones of all time, simply because of how well it's aged. Now, coming to the body of the phone, it still feels fairly premium in the hand with the metal and glass and the metal and glass design and the chamfered edges. However, there are certain nicks and dents with any of these old phones because the aluminium simply wasn't durable enough. The screen on the iPhone 5S is pretty good by today's modern standards, considering the fact that even the pixel density is same as the current iPhone XR. However, the screen is simply too small for usage. The iPhone 5S was the first phone with a fingerprint scanner, and it's still fairly quick by today's standards. But the accuracy is fairly poor, as it does take a few tries to register your finger, and doesn't read it always. The performance of the iPhone is fairly decent for lighter apps like WhatsApp and stock apps. However, for heavier apps, you can see the iPhone's age. It does take a fair amount of time to load these apps, as the A7 processor isn't as powerful as the current Snapdragons and A11s of the world. However, you have to consider the fact that this phone is 5 years old and still can keep up and open modern apps. However, I don't recommend gaming on this phone, as even the slightest of games heats the phone too much and it hinders you from holding the phone and using it properly. So if you do game on this, I recommend you get a power bank and a case. Heavier apps like navigation do work, but it significantly drains the battery. In fact, in one test of mine, it drained the battery from 50 to 64% for 10 minutes of navigation. And I will get to the battery life in a later segment. The network speeds on the iPhone 5S are fairly decent and are pretty on par with today's flagships. However, The battery significantly gets drained when you connect to 4G LTE. Now, opening Amazon Alexa, it shows you the age of the iPhone. It just takes too much time to open the app because the A7 just can't keep up with the heavier tasks. So if your usage is for light apps like WhatsApp, music and so on and so forth, the iPhone 5S is more than capable. The speakers in the phone are pretty good even by today's standards. However, there is only a single bottom firing speaker and can get blocked up quite easily. It does possess the good number of sensors, which even many Samsung budget and Samsung phones of today still do not have, like a compass sensor, gyroscope sensor, proximity sensor, and so on. It is amazing to think that a phone this old is still future-proof. Now, coming to the main selling point of this phone for the price point is the camera. The 8-megapixel front-facing camera does take amazing stills, as I will show you in the later video, but it takes 1080p video. However, the front camera is only a 1.2 megapixel and is not worth using. But for decent stills and video, it is a very good phone, especially for the price point, and nothing else can touch it. Now, the Achilles heel of this phone is the battery life. Even buying secondhand, it lasts a top 1 hour with moderate usage. So I do suggest picking up a new battery to make this phone usable. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more content. Peace out.